yesterday. All my troubles seem so far away. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. All right, let's do the Beatles song Yesterday. Let's do a quick lesson on that today. It's the most recorded song in history in terms of covers and all of that. One of the most popular Beatles songs ever, maybe the most popular, and made popular, of course, by Paul McCartney, written by him. It's a pretty easy song to learn, and let's see if we can go through it. First, go through the chords. You start off on what's called a G5, and Paul actually played it with his guitar tuned down a full step. That means two frets worth, two half notes worth. So when you play along with the record, when you play that G, it sounds like an F. Yesterday. But the chord shapes he used were the G in standard tuning. So let's learn it that way. If you want to tune your guitar down and play along with Paul in the original, feel free to do that. So start off with your G5 chord. That's a standard G chord where you add the second string, third fret with your, I used my third finger to do that, so regular G chord with that D note added. And all Paul did was play that bass note on his right hand. Okay, and then the second chord is F sharp minor. All my troubles seem so... Then E minor. Far away. Then go to a D and a C chord. Now in... Back to the D. Looks as though they're... Back to your G5. Here to stay. F sharp minor. Oh, E minor. I be A7. C, yes, G, today. And then you repeat that for the verse. Second verse, suddenly. I'm not half the man I used to be. Okay, so what he's doing on the right hand is he plays the bass root note of most of the chords for the G. And then with his fingers, you can either flick it. I think he kind of flicked it. Or you can play it with your fingers with an upstroke, but which I like to do. But 1, 2, 3, 4. 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then you keep that bass note going. So like when you go to the F sharp minor, E, F sharp in the bass, B in the bass, E in the bass, C, D in the bass, G in the bass, E in the bass, A in your A7 chord, C. So that's pretty much how you play the right hand all the way through. You just keep alternating the root note of the chord with a little bit of strumming on the rest of the chord. And that's how you do the right hand. Okay, now finally, the last thing we want to learn is the little. Why she had to go. I guess the chorus or bridge. And it starts off and you come back. I believe in yesterday. Okay, then you go to F sharp minor. Why? Then B7. She. E minor. D, C, go. Walk to A minor.
I don't know.
D7. She wouldn't sing. Then hit the G sus by putting on the C note here on the second string, first fret. And then back to your F sharp minor. I, B7, then E minor, D, C, walk down, A minor, D7, back to your G5. Okay, and for the right hand, during that part, I just play the bass note, the root note, and then kind of pluck the third string, the first string, and the second string, and a kind of pattern where I go 6-3-bow, 6-3-bow. And you kind of bass note and squeeze the bottom three strings at the same time. So there you go. You got all the pieces for yesterday. Practice that, you'll have it down. Let's play a little bit up to speed, see how it sounds. Yesterday, all my troubles seemed so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why? Yesterday.